Have you ever wondered what it would be like to do a backflip off of one foot? Well, today I'm going to teach you how to do the gainer. My name is Dom Lewis and I'm here in my home gym, All American Flames Gymnastix, where I started coaching 12 years ago. Over the past 12 years, what I've been doing is traveling around the world, doing clinics, seminars, private lessons, and a lot of online coaching. So today you guys are going to get a sneak peek glimpse at some of what I do when I'm doing all these lessons around the world, but here on YouTube instead. Now, before we get started, I always like to stretch and do a lot of good warming up, and a lot of the times while I'm doing that stuff, I like to use my Recovapro. This is my massage gun. It is one of my all-time favorite recovery tools, and I use it like nonstop every day. It helps not just with training, but just like helping you feel good and healthy throughout life. It helps relax your muscles, break up lactic acid so you don't get sore. Yeah, this thing is just, this is the best. Now, I actually have a discount code for one of these, and it is Dometric. I'm going to leave the link down so you can get yourself one of these amazing tools. All right, now, obviously, one thing you want to know before trying a gainer would be an actual backflip. Now, when first starting these, you want to do it in a safe place. So if you do have access to a gym, especially one that has a foam pit, you can practice doing them into a foam pit. You can practice doing them onto a rezi mat. You can practice doing them on trampoline, which I'll show you in just a moment. Now, when practicing a gainer on the trampoline, depends on which direction you swing. I am a righty twister, so I swing my left leg. So I'm going to approach the trampoline and jump on, landing on my right leg and swing my left. So again, when approaching the trampoline, what you're going to do is jump onto whichever leg of the direction you're going to be twisting or flipping. And for me, again, that is my right leg. I swing up my left, and you can watch as I wait until the trampoline pushes back against me, and then I swing. Now, most of you will be lefty twisters, which means you will be swinging your right leg up, landing on your left, swinging that right leg up nice and high. That is not necessarily my most comfortable way, but I will show you so you guys can kind of see what it should look like for you guys going your direction. So, as you saw, I landed on my left leg, swung my right leg up nice and high, and then completed my flip. So after doing it on a surface like a trampoline, you can do it on something like a tumble track, which is more similar to a floor or an air track because it does not bounce you as much as a trampoline, but it does give you a little bit of bounce. So for me, what I'm going to do is land here on my right leg because I swing my left up, me being a righty twister. So for you guys, you land on your left leg, swing that right leg up. So watch how I swing here. Now, one of the most beneficial positions in all of tricking is called the eagle. Now, what eagle means is whenever you land for a swing through, you need to make sure that you are landing on whichever leg. So for me, my right leg, those arms are behind me a bit. So I'm like an eagle with my wings out really far. My right leg slightly bent. My left leg is going to be behind me. So this is eagle position. Now, you don't want to drop your chest too low because it's very hard to swing from this position. You'll probably clip whatever foot you're trying to swing. So here I am, chest is up a bit. Can lean forward, but not drop down. So chest is up, right leg slightly bent, arms are back, my left leg is here. This is eagle position, and this is gonna set you up for a proper, huge swing through. So now I'm gonna show you kind of what it's like to do those swing throughs, so you can watch my eagle position, you can watch how much I swing my swing leg, so my left leg, how high it comes up when I do these, and I'm gonna show you some. So you can see everyone I landed, I was in eagle position, swing that left leg up nice and high to help me lift into the air, and then as I come back around, I'm landing back into that eagle position. All right, now after you've done your gainers, practicing them into a pit, on a trampoline, on a tumble track, anything like that, you can work on doing them on the spring floor or grass. Now, if you don't have access to a gym, I know it is really hard to get your training in. That's how I grew up training, was outside up until I was 16 when I finally came in here, but if you got to use what you have. So if you only have grass, take all these tips and pointers and still try to apply those the best you can in a safe way. If you need someone to help you, someone to spot you or anything like that, make sure that you're getting some proper help. And again, if you have access to a gym, make sure you utilize that. Now, moving it to the floor, it is not going to be that much different than the tumble track. It does not dip as much as a tumble track or a trampoline. So you really have to make sure you're utilizing those fast twitch muscles. Make sure that right when you land on that foot, so for me, my right foot, right when you land onto it, when you're going to swing, you're pushing off of it right away. So almost like a really hard calf raise, and that'll help you get that gainer. So I'm gonna show you really quickly, and you can make sure you're paying attention to my eagle position and my swing for a gainer. One more time. Now, what you can see there is, I land on that foot and I go right away into that swing, but my leg is not too close. I have it nice and far back so I can kick it, almost like I'm trying to kick a ball really far. And so as I land, right when I hit this eagle position, swing up nice and hard, get a nice high gainer. If you want to see any more tutorials like this, make sure you subscribe. And if you do want to see any more type of gainer variations, make sure you comment down below. Let me know which gainers you want to work on, and I can make sure that I take those into consideration when making my next tutorial. Now, to reiterate the things that I just taught you, make sure that you are landing in an eagle position when you start your swing. So, chest just slightly out to the front, not too far down, because when that happens, your swing leg can't make it all the way. So, chest here, running a little bit, whatever leg you plant, so mine being my right leg, bent just a little bit, planted nice and firm, my swing leg behind me, and those arms a bit behind to help you properly swing up. Because again, the biggest issues that'll happen, especially with that eagle position, is that chest dropping too low, and it makes the swing very difficult and pretty dangerous for the ankles and knees. I've been filming a ton of tutorials lately, and my most recent one was on a flash kick, my favorite backflip variation. If you guys want to check that out, you can hit right here.